If you're experiencing hard starting or a no start, stalling, surging, or a general lack of power from the vehicle when trying to accelerate or when ascending an incline, these are some of the symptoms of a failing fuel pump, and you may want to check your fuel pressure to rule out a weak or bad fuel pump. Fuel pressure problems can be difficult to diagnose as they may not even trip a check engine light. Today I'll be showing how to read fuel pressure on a scan tool. I'll also demonstrate how to test if your fuel pressure is functioning within its normal operation range. This test is going to apply to a wide range of vehicles and most scanners will be able to run the test. Now let's get this. This test applies to cars which have a fuel pressure sensor, and these are usually cars built on the CAN OBD protocol. Generally, all cars made for the US market as from 2008 have the CAN OBD protocol and support this test. If your car falls within this list, with this test there will be no need to start looking for a fuel pressure gauge if you want to measure fuel pressure. I'll be using the Autel MP808TS, but as I mentioned previously, most scanners that are able to read manufacturer live data will be sufficient. Ideally, you want to have your car at operating temperature before running the test, as cold temperatures can affect fuel pressure. Let's get into the test. Your scan tool setup might be different, but you basically just want to select your vehicle, and under the engine module you select live data. Using generic OBD live data may not show you the data points from the fuel pressure sensor. I'm in a 2017 Accord, and as you can see, I've already selected live data. Next, you want to select RPM, target fuel pressure, and actual fuel pressure. Your scan tool may define these fuel pressure data points differently, but you can always differentiate these by looking at the description of the PID. The target fuel pressure is what the ECM has commanded the fuel pump to maintain the pressure at, while the actual is the real-time readings coming from the fuel pressure sensor.
So let me group those three PIDs so that it's easier for us to observe. Then I'll start the car. The engine is already warm. This is the target fuel pressure, 507 psi. That means the ECU is commanding the fuel pump to deliver this pressure to the fuel rail. Here you can see good correlation between the reading from the fuel pressure sensor as well as the target fuel pressure. What you want to do first of all is to raise this to about 1500 RPM. That way you're going to be putting more load on the fuel pump, and if there are any issues with the fuel pump, you're more likely to have variance between these two readings at higher RPM. So let's do that. Let's take it up to 1500. So not much variance, as you can see it's maintained. Then you want to go to between 2500 to about 3000 as well. So we're at 3000, and as you can see, there isn't any much variance either. So this tells you that there's good correlation between the actual and the target fuel pressure, and you drop that. Some degree of variance is expected because of losses within the system. But if you're seeing, for example, if you have the target at 500 and you're seeing a reading of about 300 from the pressure sensor or something way over like 700, I mean, you can definitely tell that there's a problem. If it's on the lower end of the spectrum, then you'll be looking at fuel delivery issues, clogged filter, and so on and so forth. If it's above, it could be the fuel pressure regulator and other things. Hope this was helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.